always have someone to talk to, be it a friend, a close family member whom you can trust, then tapos dahil hindi naman din
na hindi magja-judge or dapat bawal mga judgmental. Hello everyone and welcome to our episode this week. Ayan. So October is
Mental Health Month.
Mental Health Awareness Month. All right. So that's why we decided to have a special episode regarding mental health
and finance. At saka kaka-celebrate lang ng Mental Health Day noong October 10.
Kasi ang mental health usually nakakapit yan sa financial health, di ba? Marami akong kilala na talagang na-stress, na-de-depress, nagkakaroon ng emotional anxiety because they are in financial stress. May financial problems or financial issue na kinakaharap, no? They're taking care of a financial problem. And of course, nakaka-affect sa ating mental health yon.
So before moving forward, so konting trigger warning lang.
Trigger warning, no?
Oh, in case, no. So if you want to watch with a friend, better. But if you can watch it alone, okay lang.
Comes all right. Sige.
So moving forward. So because I'll be discussing some stats.
Okay, mga statistics muna
regarding anxiety and depression.
All
taken
right.
From WHO, so World Health Organization and other sites.
All right.
And of course, no. Some inputs from my dear friend Terence Ang. From Unilab Foundation.
All right.
Me and Sir Renzi attended their seminars last year.
All right. Sige.
So, shout out na lang kay Sir Renzi.
Hello, Sir Renzi.
Sige. So first, around 800,000 people commit suicide every year. So that's a rate of 11 out of 100,000 people.
Mm-hmm.
So this is also the second cause of death between 15 to 29 years
mga,
old.
Mga bata eh, no?
Mm-hmm. As per 2016. Tapos, as per 2015 data, 11.16 attempt commit suicide between ages 13 to 17.
Mga bata.
Bata pa rin. But, mas mataas yung attempts.
Meron 16.8% na attempts.
Uh-oh.
Ano yung reason, usually?
When I meet my friends who have also anxiety and depression, it's either a past trauma na ayaw nilang i-disclose, which is fine naman, or may certain pang-developmental or between, it's already dependent on yung environment nila, on their experiences din in school or maybe some
workplace.
Workplace or baka kasi may past traumatic event. Sometimes, though may not be a cause, bullying or baka pressure from parents, etc. Though, din natin masasabi because we're not psychologists, psychiatrists.
How often do you hear people na nagkakaroon ng depression or anxiety or mental health issue because of financial reasons?
Financial reasons. So far, wala pa on my side.
Mm-hmm.
But for your case, baka marami, dahil marami din kasi nag-email sa'yo. But for
malalaking utang.
But for my case, sa age group ko, usually it's because of sometimes loneliness.
Really, social and relationship.
So sa Philippine context naman, around 3.3 million Filipinos suffer from depressive disorders.
So depressive disorders,
So general na siya. So around 3 males and then 2 females.
Mas maraming males.
Yes, which is consistent naman sa other studies.
That's surprising kasi ako, I've had this impression na yung mga babae, mas emotional sila.
Yeah, but for some reason, mas because sa women they can handle their emotions better than
and I think they express
it better.
They are more free to express it. Kasi pag lalaki kailangan ano eh, parang suck it up, di ba? So that leads to that
yung ratio. Tapos in other countries there has been initiatives already in promoting yung men to open up na that it's okay to talk about it.
Yes.
Because it's also part of their well-being and also personal growth din.
All right.
So, moving forward. So, this is sa Philippines naman, there are only 1.7 to 2 mental health professionals or geared to address mental health needs out of 100,000 individuals.
Yes, yes.
And for psychiatry, it's only 0.8 or almost 1. So, uh-huh. 1 to 100,000. So, there is still that gap. But the good news is, kaka-pass lang na mental health law last year.
Mm-hmm.
Tapos, kaka-sign lang yung IRR niya. Or yung implementing rules and regulations
yes,
niya.
Uh-huh.
So, which is good.
Yes, and especially sa mga kabataan na nanonood sa atin.
Uh-huh.
There are actually mga very active na Twitter accounts na nag-address sa mga mental health issues. Mm-hmm. No? And ako, personally, one of my favorite people to connect with, si Doc Gia.
Yeah, medyo familiar.
Si Doc Gia Season. No? She talks about mental health and... gives advice, no, especially yung mga love problems, no, sa Twitter, no, and of course, we'll put a link dun sa mga pages where you can get in touch with someone, talk to someone when if you're having some mental issues, no, or mental health problems, no.
Yes.
But of course, personally, on my experience, may mga tao talaga na untrigger, sabi mo nga, usually may trigger yan eh, or trauma. A few of them, it comes from financial stress, no, or financial anxiety, lalo na yung mga nabaon sa utang, no?
Usually tapos, debt problems.
Yeah. Yung hinaharas na ng mga lawyers,
minsan yung bank,
mga collecting agencies, and aside from yung nakukuha nilang pressure from these collecting agencies, meron din siyang element of shame, no? Kasi ayaw ipaalam sa mga magulang or sa kapatid or whoever na meron silang financial problem.
Mm-hmm.
And personally, ako ang i-advise ko is open up. You need to talk to someone na who would understand. So, of course, kung hindi kayo comfortable sa parents,
you can be a friend or a trusting family member. Para lang may kasama ka and you can also express yourself.
Yes.
Bali, it's difficult kung binabottle up nyo lang.
Yes.
Kasi mag-explode tapos it might complicate things.
And actually, that's what usually happens. Kapag sinasarili mo yung problem mo, be it financial or emotional, it will, ano, it doesn't have the tendency, it will surely parang explode, no, or it will really affect you, and sometimes the adverse effects becomes long term and permanent. Mm-hmm. So before even that happens, it will really help to reach out to someone and talk to. And actually, sa Wealtharchy, we've had cases na aside from helping that person dun sa kanilang financial plan, we actually also refer them to our partner
psychologist, no? Psychiatrist.
Yes.
Actually, ganun din yung ginagawa ko minsan sa friends.
Pang
nag-o-offer ako ng suggestions kung saan sila kumuha ng psychiatrist or psychologist. Uh-oh. Because it helps them then in their personal growth and well-being.
Yes.
Well-being, and they're professionally trained to do so.
Yes. Siguro isa sa mga misconception, no? Na para sa akin dapat mabago is of course all of us we go to the dentist regularly, no, every 6 months
or annually, depende din.
Isang mental health professional, it's kind of same way, no. It will do very well with our mental health if we talk to a mental health professional every now and then, just to, alam mo yun, kahit check up.
No, kasi check up or kamustahin ka.
Oo, kamusta lang. Just for you to be able to get a view or a good perspective of how are you doing.
Okay?
And sometimes, I know na people who are facing mga mental health problems, it affects their work, which leads to their financial stress also, no? Sometimes it's the financial stress that is causing their emotional stress, no? So magkakabit yan, and I believe that you cannot just solve yung financial problem without addressing the ba? Personal. Mamaya may emotional,
may emotional
cause siya, no? One very concrete example dyan was we were able to help a client na yung husband niya may gambling problem.
So nagsusugal siya.
Yung husband niya, hindi siya.
Bali may addiction yung husband.
Oo. Tapos siya, of course, being the breadwinner of the family, no, the wife, she's facing a lot of financial stress, no, kasi kailangan i-control yung ano, yung mga gastos nila. But we can help them how to pay off their debts and take care of their finances, but the problem will not go away if until they consult a psychologist or a psychiatrist or a marriage counselor even to address the gambling addiction. Yeah?
So, mayroon kasi na nagbabayad ka ng utang pero
yung root cause, din. Diba?
Susugal ka.
Lalo na yung iba na they deal with their anxiety and their depression by shopping. Yes, diba? May mga ganun, diba?
Mga impulsive buyers.
So, of course, we can help you take care of your finances, but you also need a professional to help guide you, to help you how to get through yung inyong mga mental health problems, no, or mental health issues.
Tapos sa end ko naman, for those naman experiencing anxiety or depression, make sure na may emergency funds kayo.
Mm-hmm.
Just in case biglaan nag-job loss or biglaan...
Kasi mga major triggers yan.
Baka major triggers or baka may bad days sa office or something. So baka kailangan mo mag-distress or be with a friend.
Yes.
So at least may pondo kayo para sa mga gastos.
Yeah. So another, ano yan? Another...
Para another buffer.
Yes. And yun nga, another reason why it's important to have an emergency fund, no? And ako, I'm looking forward to... for our government na i-recognize yung mga mental health VLs, no, yung bakasyon because meron kang mental health day na, ano yun?
Actually may mga articles ako nabasa online na you can file for a sick leave for a mental health reason.
Ngayon meron na. Dati kasi parang hindi siya accepted, eh.
Bali, no? Parang sick leave siya.
Oo.
So at least meron kayong leeway in case you're not feeling well emotionally or may nangyari. You can just tell your supervisor, manager, or boss man
na
baka I might need to take a day off because I'm experiencing this and that.
Yes. And of course, yun nga, having an emergency fund will help you through these days. Kasi hindi naman sinasabi na after a day, okay ka na, di ba? I've met people who've taken like 2 weeks off from work because it's really not... he's not really in his element, no, to work, no. So of course, having a buffer fund would really go a long way in helping you become better, no.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, actually, yung mga psychologists and psychiatrists or mental health professionals, although there are some clinics na libre, pero yung mga talagang sa hospitals, minsan mahal, actually mahal yung ano, per session, no. So of course, that's also one reason na if you're dealing with a mental health issue or it runs in the family, di ba?
So partnerin yan sa budgeting nyo.
Yes, yung inyong ano, consultation, how do your session.
Okay, yung actually sa cash flow analysis ko, parating may therapy fee. In case, no, the client has depression or anxiety. So
for an average person, how often ba? Once a week? Twice a month?
It depends on the person's budget and needs. Mayroon akong kilala na twice a month. Mayroon iba once a month pumupunta. Tapos, as far as I know, when I check, yung national center natin ng mental health in Mandaluyong offers around 400 pesos na consultation fee.
Yes.
So, may access naman. NPGH, UST din.
Yes.
Med also has their psychiatric services.
Yes. Ako, I know yung sa UST, may free service sila doon.
Meron din sa Ateneo.
Mm-hmm. Alright. So, may gusto pa bang idagdag?
Just to summarize sa sinabi natin. So, always have your emergency fund.
Yes, that's really very important.
To always have someone to talk to, be it a friend, a close family member, whom you can trust then. Tapos, dahil hindi naman din
na hindi mag-judge. Dapat bawal mga judgmental.
Meron kasing, because we don't want to, because we're promoting the discourse, so this breaks the stigmatization din.
Mm-hmm.
And then, lastly, always do your budgeting financially.
Yes,
Tapos, if may wife or husband ka na experiencing a mental health issue, pwede mong kausapin. Tapos, you can go through counseling din if needed.
Yes,
yes. Tapos, we're always available naman. In case...
Yeah, we're always here to help you with your financial concerns. And that's one of the reasons why we like getting to know our clients better. Kasi sometimes the root cause of their financial stress is an emotional or a mental health problem. So,
tapos we can also refer them to our personal
mga partners,
partners natin na psychiatrists and psychologists.
Yes. So, of course, we're here to help you with your financial issues.
Mm-hmm.
And if you email us at admin@wealtharchy.com, we'll try to see ano ba talaga yung situation nyo. And if we know that another professional can help you with your situation, then we will definitely refer them to you also. But of course, let's all see our mental health as part of our overall physical well-being. Diba? Meron tayong mga annual physical exam. Meron tayong every 6 months na oral prophylaxis. We go to the dentist.
Or may APE pa.
Yes.
Treat your mental health as your physical health.
Yes. It's part of our overall well-being. And siguro, final tip, no? Something that I always advocated, especially sa mga friends ko na who are facing mental health issues. Yung simple exercise of meditating, no? Mindful meditation, and of course physical exercise. This really helps sa ating physical and emotional well-being, no? So try to learn mindful meditation, and then always have time sa routine ninyo ng physical activity. No? So, those two...
Or even if hindi physical activity, pwede rin poetry, any forms of
mga artistic expressions. No?
Pwede din.
Yes. Alright. So, and these things, they don't have to be very expensive. No?
Like,
of course, mindful meditation. There are a lot of tutorials on YouTube. And then... Yeah. And taking a brisk walk. It's a physical... Ano, and of course, we all have our cell phones. We can be creative with our cell phones. I have friends who do photography on their mobile phones. No? So, anything artistic, may mga drawing apps na that they can do. Or even just open up your notepad and write your own poetry. Yeah, so, yung artistic expression, it's also very good for our mental health. No?
Yes.
Alright, so right. I guess that's it. So, thank you for watching. So, if you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up and share it to your friends.
Tapos kung may comments kayo, suggestions, or if you want to promote a discussion, please comment down below na
yes,
lang.
Alright. And then, please don't forget to check out the description or this video on YouTube so that you can
check
see yung mga links kung saan sila pwedeng humingi ng tulong or mag-reach out. Yes, alright. So, again, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and see you again next week. Alright?
Alright, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.